All right. So, good evening everyone. JC here from Investagrams. Meron tayong special session para sa video na to. Recently, isa sa mga pinakabagong listing sa stock exchange is yung A-REIT or Ayala REITs. So, didiscuss natin ano nga ba tong REITs. And bago siya, it's the first time in the history. And dahil special itong asset na to, itong REIT na to, unang-una. Special rin yung kasama natin sa session na to. So I'd like to introduce one of my colleagues, our research analyst, si Ray. Ray, what's up?
Hi, JC. Thanks so much for having me here. So I guess to introduce myself first, no, because I'm quite new here. So yeah, I've had experience working with you guys at Investagrams. But even outside of that, I had an internship at a brokerage company. So, mga research reports, I was helping out. And then I also took an internship in an asset management company. So, sa mga mutual funds, UITFs in the Philippines. So, I got to see both yung sell side and buy side. That's what they call it in finance. But right now, what I'm actually doing is I am working for an investment bank. It's an international investment bank. So, right now, I get to see mga deals mostly in Southeast Asia. So, naka-work na ako in mga IPOs in Thailand. Mga follow-on offerings in Singapore, mga bond issuances, so mga hundreds of millions of dollars, even umaabot pa nga minsan ng billion dollars. And then of course, meron ding experience in the Philippines, mga bond offerings mostly. And then, yeah, right now, we're gonna talk about A-REIT, so yung REIT ni Ayala Land, and it's another capital markets deal, so there's a lot to talk about here, and yeah, let's get to it.
Ayun. So, para lang makilala nyo si Ray, no? Ang ganda ng introduction niya. So, ako personally, I'm not much of a fundamentalist. So, kilala nyo ako bilang short, medium-term trader. So, 70-80% trading perspective ako. Konting fundamentals lang. So, very basic or foundation lang. So, isa sa mga nag-guide sa akin is si Ray. Ang daming experience nito ni Ray locally and then globally as well. So, we're really honored to have him here. And ano, ito yung isa sa mga nagbibigay sa atin ng insights sa Investagrams. So okay, Ray, simulan natin. I think the first question is, ano ba yung REIT, di ba? So pakita natin yung imahe natin para ma-explain natin ng mabuti. Ano ba yung REIT and paano siya gumagana?
Yep, sige. Wait, share natin yung screen, no? Okay, tapos full screen natin. Kita na ba?
Yeah.
Okay. So what is a REIT, no? Basically, it's kind of like a stock, but not exactly. It's a stock in a sense na, yes, it's a company. It's separate. It's a separate entity. And you get investors. So you have investors who buy shares of the company, or in this case, units of the REIT. So sa REIT, unit holders. Sa stocks, shareholders. So ang binibili mo sa REIT ay units of participation dun sa mga kanilang properties and yung sa income ng properties na yun. So like any stock, of course, yung goal nila is to make money, to make profits. And then what's special about REITs is, in particular sa Philippines, although galing sa Singapore yata tong slide na to, pero sa Philippines, I believe 90% of the distributable income has to be paid in dividends to the investors. So, yung mga stocks natin sa Philippines, nakakita tayo mga dividend payout policies nila, sila lang nagsiset nun. It's possible na may stocks na hindi nagbabayad ng dividends, di ba? Yeah. Pero meron din mga mas mature na company, nagpa-payout sila, let's say, 30%, 50% of last year's net income. Sa REITs, no matter if it's a young company or it's 10 years old, the law requires na 90% of the distributable income is paid out to investors.
Interesting. So, ang key difference nito is versus yung stocks, di ba? Shares of a company. Think of the REITs naman as units of the buildings, di ba? The properties being listed,
yes,
tama ba?
That's correct, yes. So, as the name implies, no, real estate investment trust. So, real estate talaga yung subject ng REITs. Although, interesting, siguro something to share na rin outside of the Philippines. Nakikita na rin natin, it's not just real estate actually. So, in other countries like Singapore, we're seeing REITs of data centers and even mga, and then of course, marami ding mga warehouses, stuff like that. So, it's not just malls, hotels, hospitals. It's really any kind of physical asset that can give you stable cash flows.
Can be rented or leased, parang ganun, no?
Yes. So you're earning so, regularly.
So ito siguro yung isang katanungan ko dyan, no? As a business owner, why would I sell part ownership of my properties? Anong usual na ginagamit nila? Saan nila usually ginagamit yung capital? Bakit nila gagawin yun?
Yes, so let's say in this particular instance, si Ayala Land, di ba? Meron siyang 3 properties right now na i-re-REIT niya, i-offer niya sa public. Of course, hindi naman niya i-offer lahat. May 51% stake pa rin siya, I think. So 49% in-offer niya sa public. Yeah. And bakit niya ginagawa yun? One, it's to raise capital for Ayala Land. Kasi, I mean, there are multiple ways to raise capital. Pwede siyang mag-offer ng shares niya. Pwede siyang mag-issue ng debt. Umutang sa bank, umutang sa public, right? And then, of course, meron din ito. Ito medyo mas recent lang sa Philippines, pero in other countries, sobrang tagal nang meron. Ayun, one way to do it is to REIT some of your assets. That means, let's say, in this particular instance, meron si Ayala Land na 3 office building. Ang gusto niyang gawin is, i-list niya yung 3 office building na yun. So, yung mga investors, meron silang share in those office buildings, right? Meron silang rights to the income of those office buildings. And what will Ayala Land do with that money? Eh, well, it depends on the company. I think in Ayala Land's case, they're most likely going to use it to build even more buildings.
Yeah, I think nakita ko na ano, if I'm not mistaken, nakita ko doon sa article or sa prospectus na pang yung part of the proceeds, pambibili rin nila ng isa pang building. I guess we can proceed, Ray, with your presentation dito para ano ma-discuss natin on a deeper level ano ba yung potential ni Ayala REIT.
Yep, sige. So, I guess before that lang, why would a retail investor, diba, an individual want to buy a REIT? So, of course, a lot of us want to invest in real estate, particularly in the Philippines. It's a growth market talaga. Especially in the past 10 years, malakas yung real estate boom in the Philippines, right? Pero someone, let's say, earning 20, 30,000 a month, how can you invest in real estate? Ang mahal-mahal nga ng prices. One single property will cost you millions, right? Yeah. So, ayun yung isang advantage ng REIT is that you can own part of an office building. That's something that was previously unreachable. You would have never had rights to an office building's earnings before. And right now, with the REITs, that's something you can do, diba? So just to give like more of a background, no? REITs have been around for a very long time. I think REIT law in the Philippines was first passed in 2009 or 2010, if I'm not mistaken.
Tama.
Pero I don't know why, baka politics, baka weak implementation lang, sobrang natagalan talaga before it was finally ready, before companies were finally okay with the existing law to the point na they were ready to share, ready to issue, ready to REIT their properties, diba? So, here in the slide, this is from Twitter, from ANC Alerts. They listed down a Collier study, so REITs in selected Asian countries by size in terms of US, in terms of, I think, market cap to. So it's in US dollars, it's in billions of US dollars. We see na Japan has $128 billion of listed REITs. Singapore has 72 and so on. And then Philippines, of course, right now, zero tayo, diba? So we're quite behind of the curve, especially in terms of neighboring countries. So, of course, Japan, Singapore, Hong Kong, they're more developed. But even companies like Thailand, Malaysia, Indonesia, may $1 billion na at least, right? So I hope that someday we'll catch up to them as well, right?
Yeah, the interesting thing, parang same do sa chart natin sa stock exchange, diba? Yung market participation, halos magkalapit din.
Yep. So same goals na.
Oo nga.
And I think one way to grow that market participation then is to give more offerings din eh.
Totoo.
So not just in terms of like stock sectors, but types of investments as well. And
that's
a REIT, I think, is one of those things that can actually help. And we'll explain this more in later slides why I think that's the case. So comparison of REITs across Asia. So yun, neighboring countries, merong iba, may 2, 7, 12 REITs. And then may mga average dividend yields din, minimum public ownership. So as far as I know, our REIT law and yung implementing rules niya right now, they were patterned after the existing REIT laws of neighboring countries as well. So kita mo yung minimum public ownership nasa 25 to 30%, ours right now is a bit on the high side, 33%.
Yeah.
But it's still within the range naman, diba? More or less, it's around that area. So they mentioned, this is from Colliers pa rin, that the interesting asset class for the Philippines is office and retail. So office buildings and retail meaning mga malls. So in other countries like Hong Kong, they have hospitality. So that's mga tourism related. In Singapore, they have business parks. And they have, I think under business parks, you would have yung mga data centers as well. They have hospitality, industrial. Industrial would, I think, refer more to mga warehouses. And that's something that I think the Philippines can eventually get into as well. So yeah, just an overview of what it looks like in the region right now. And
yeah, so,
again, we're doing
so
zero, no?
Oo nga, no? At least magkaka one na. So take note natin to, guys and girls. Yung average dividend yield nasa 2.6 to 8% no across the region. So at least may expectation na tayo.
Yep, that's correct. And we'll talk about that more later on kasi this is an important point specifically for REITs. So REITs versus property stocks. So right now we have a lot of property stocks naman in the Philippines. We have SMPH, Ayala Land, RLC, Robinsons, ano ba? We have Vista Land, Double Dragon. Diba? Marami talaga. Pero there's a key difference eh. So, property stocks, their business and their revenues come from two main sources. And more often than not, it's skewed towards yung mga real estate sales. So, real estate sales, ano bang ibig sabihin yan? It means na yung property developer will buy land, right? Let's say, bumili siya ng land in Iloilo. Gagawin niya sa land na yun, magkoconstruct siya ng office tower, ng condo, ng hotel, or whatever, right? Tapos, ang pwede niyang gawin is, of course, ang gagawin niya is magbebenta siya ng mga office, ng mga condo units, for example. So that's real estate sales. Nagbebenta siya ng residential units. Rental income, ito yung nag-construct siya, tapos ipaparent niya, ipapalease niya sa mga tenants. So to companies who need office space, ayun, that's rental income for the property company. For stores, for cinemas that need space in malls, that's rental income, right? So REIT, it's almost, I think, or more likely, it's going to be purely rental income. So if you're looking for mga property development place, a REIT is not for you. And then sources of returns, for stocks, of course, I think this is in Stocks 101, right? You have capital appreciation and dividends. How do you make money from stocks, right? Sorry. So either price goes up or down. If price goes up, may capital appreciation ka. And then now and then, maybe regularly, the company will pay out dividends to its shareholders. So you have dividends. So REIT, so stocks, capital appreciation madalas yung highlight. So dun nagagaling yung bulk of returns. So REITs, it's more on dividends. So may capital appreciation component pa rin because REITs are traded. So prices can go up and down pa rin. And then finally, if we look at yung underlying drivers of returns, it's almost the same except na because may real estate sales component, and typically this is majority for property stocks, underlying driver would be selling prices and construction costs. So right now, it depends on who you ask, diba? Pero they say na may mga discount na raw when you buy properties because of COVID, right?
Yeah.
Kasi nagsisialisan na raw mga, or there are fewer investors who want to buy pieces of property, for example, diba? So REIT, wala kang ganung concern. Your main concerns should be rental rates and occupancy ng buildings. Kasi if you have, let's say, 100,000 square meters of leasable space, pero 50% occupied lang, diba? Parang that very much drives yung returns and eventually yung dividends na matatanggap ng investors. Kasi yeah. Remember, yung focus natin dito is dividend growth and dividends in specific, right?
So, just to add there, so ang pinaka tinitigdan sa REITs is yung occupancy rate nga. So, kung may property ka, as long as fully occupied yung mga nagre-renta dun sa offices mo, then goods yun. I think one experience na pwede ko i-share dito, yung nasa Singapore kami, yung mga retailers sa Singapore, like yung mga malls, yung mga main retail stores, ang dami doon nag-empty out na. So mm-hmm. I think kaya nagkaroon ng volatility sa mga Singapore REITs early on the last year. Kasi yun, yung shift papuntang digital, maraming store nagsasarado. So kapag yung REIT, yung properties ng REIT mo, unti-unti nang umaalis yung tenants, then yun, mag-ingat-ingat ka kapag ganun. So ganun natin tinitingnan yung REITs in terms of gaano ba karami nagre-rent sa kanila, ano yung rental prices. So yun.
Yep. And I guess to add to that din, no, siguro like one way of looking at this is when you're investing in a rental income property versus a property stock, right? It's a property stock, for me, there's really more risks involved because you're exposed nga to price, to the risk of selling prices and construction costs, plus yung reputation ng developer, right? I guess that's one thing na a lot of people look at when they buy properties as well, right?
So yeah.
And then just a quote from an online article I found, no? REITs are less susceptible to price variation. So it goes in line with what we said, nga na source of returns would be primarily from dividends rather than capital appreciation or price returns. So public REITs have experienced less volatility than the S&P over the last 40 years, likely as a result of a high dividend yield and a share price that is easier to value. So again, yung assets lang ng REIT would mostly be yung buildings na nililease nila. So sobrang dali nang i-value nun compared to a typical company, right? And then less volatile nga kasi less price action. So it's really more of a dividend play. And then just siguro, I guess a lot of people have seen this chart or a similar chart na rin. This is a core concept in finance. If you want higher returns, you need to take on more risk. So at the lowest end of the yung investment spectrum natin, if you want really low risks, you can invest in government bonds kasi that's sure to be paid out by the government, diba? So alam ko right now may nag-o-offer ng 5-year bonds online na yata, diba?
RTB point. Retail bonds nila in-offer na sa 5,000 minimum, parang ganyan.
Yep. They're putting it online na rin. And I think 5 years, 2.7% more or less yata.
2.6, parang ganun.
Yeah. So, mababa yung returns, no? 2.6%.
So pero ano, parang zero risk ka, halos.
Yep. Parang siguradong babayaran ka kahit mabankrupt na lahat na ibang companies sa Philippines. Mm. Government pa rin yan. They can print money. So, babayaran ka talaga. Or, diba? That's almost likely the case, right? So, okay. If you move up one step, so risk return chart natin, you move to mga corporate bonds naman. So the likes of Jollibee, SM Ayala, they all have bonds in the public market. They all have investors who lent them money, diba? So you can't guarantee na magkaka net income, natataas yung price, yung stock price mo this year. Pero it's more likely na babayaran mo yung bonds mo, yung bondholders mo, yung investors mo ng interest. And when the time comes, pag nag-mature na yung bonds, babayaran mo rin yung principal, di ba? And then sa pinaka-end ng spectrum, sanay na tayo dun sa stocks or yung common shares, di ba? So stocks ni Ayala Land, ni SMPH, all of the stocks you can think of right now, those are on the higher end of the risk-return spectrum. Kasi we know that stock prices can go down by a lot. This year, they went down 50%, di ba? But there's also a significant potential na tumaas sila. So over the past 10 years, ano bang CAGR ng stocks natin? More like, well, prior to COVID, di ba?
Siguro above 10%. 12%,
Yep, for some of them, no? So yung REITs, I would, just me, ha? I guess some people would view this differently because it's quite a fluid situation then. For REITs, I would put them in the same class or the same bucket as mga preferred shares. So typically, diba, do you see traders trading preferred shares? Hindi masyado, right?
Yeah.
So one thing that REITs and preferred shares have in common is that may expected dividend ka every year and it's less likely to be volatile yung prices niya. So I would put them somewhere in between corporate bonds and common stocks. Sometimes medyo may overlap sa risk and return, pero more or less it's in between.
Agree.
So that's how I'd explain.
So parang ano pa rin siya, no? Parang shares pa rin, pero the boring kind, yung mga parang F-gen, FG, yung mga hindi pinapansin pero minsan gagalaw, parang ganoon, mga
yes.
High dividend plays, illiquid, kasi yeah. Mga long term halos lahat ng ano humahawak.
Yeah. may not necessarily be liquid naman, pero the high dividend play for sure dapat.
Oh.
Or that's their goal at least, diba? If maging low dividend yan, no, babagsak din siguro yung price niyan.
Totoo, totoo. So ito, ito para alam natin, parang may tinigdan ako dito eh. What are the best REITs in Singapore from IPO? So ito, kunyari, example, Capital Land Commercial Trust. Annualized return. So yung return, ano na yan, no? Dividends lang ba to or pati price action na rin?
May price action na rin yan.
Ayun. So tignan natin. So top 10, 7%, 9, 7%. Yung top 8, 8.66. Tapos tignan natin yung top 5. Top 5, ayun, 10% average 10 to 14. Return.
Not bad.
Ito but, not bad, tama.
One thing to consider is Singapore has 44 REITs. Oh. So yung top 10 lang yung umabot ng 7% plus. Yung 34 REITs lower than 7%.
Oh, interesting stat. So in terms of probability, 66-70%, hindi niya matalo yung 7% returns, no?
Yeah. Something to take note of lang din, no? So just
okay.
So we get a better idea of the big picture. Pero yes, it's good to show these stats na they can outperform. A few of them can outperform, no?
Ayun, I think importante yun kasi di ba, let's say, mag-IPO yan, 30. Tapos, ini-expect natin, uy, shit, IPO, APVI, MM, para baka nandun yung retail traders eh. I'm sure kung hindi natin ginawa to, maraming educators dyan, nandyan naman yung iba sa YouTube, di ba? Pero sa audience natin sa Investagrams and to most retail traders, I bet they wouldn't take the time to really analyze on a big picture view, on a regional perspective, ano ba yung usual na galawan ng REIT. So at least yeah. Ito, nakikita natin na, okay, 60-70% chance on a 3-year, 5-year time frame, ang annual returns nila ay below 7% sa Singapore's case. Ha? Kasi 10 lang yung nag-above 7%. Eh, yung 30, below 7.
Yan, so okay. Yung table yata nasa baba, oh, if you scroll down. May mga nag-negative po.
Ayun, tama. May mga nag-negative.
Nag-negative. Sa lagay na yan, may dividends na yan. Ha?
Okay, so tingin tayo ng charts. So, saan yan?
Yung CMOU.
CMOU?
Yep.
Ito. Nandun yeah, ba to sa top si Keppel? Wala.
I don't think so.
Ah, wala siya. Okay.
Oh, sige, yun, nasa list naman siya. Keppel.
Ayun. So tignan natin, guys. Ito. Nagsimula siya 2018. Ayan. So, alam nyo naman yung regional na galaw. So, kunyari, ito. 2019, 90 cents siya. Diba? Konting excitement. First week. Tapos may breakdown. Ayan na.
Ayan, nag-cause yan.
Baka... kung mall, kung retail ba to, baka ano, yung weak occupancy or something. So,
not sure if it's retail.
Oh, hindi na tayo sure doon. Pero at least, ito, nakikita nyo yung reality ng ano ng REITs. Kumbaga, hindi porket meron yang on the listing date, meron tayong 4% or 5% na return, eh parang ano na yan, stronghold na hindi na magbe-breakdown, di ba? Maraming factors na pwede mag-trigger ng mga ganitong movements.
Yep. Tama. Check pa tayo ng iba pa. Like, Prime US REIT.
Anong ano nun? Prime?
Prime space US. Ay, wala.
Teka, dito.
Check lang natin. Ano mang... hindi ako familiar sa tickers eh.
Prime US REIT. Ito.
Mm-hmm. Sige, try that one.
Singapore to?
Yes, pero I think USD denominated siya.
Oh, Prime Oxmo USD. Parang, ayun, ito.
Yeah. Yep, that's more like a normal chart, no?
Oh, pero ano rin, tignan nyo, okay. So, initial, sige, uptrend.
So, stable. And then, natamaan ng COVID.
Oo nga, no? COVID.
This
tama.
One is office spaces in the US. Pero SGX listed siya.
Okay, ayun. So, ito, kumbaga, hindi porkit may fixed yield na yung isang REIT, eh, matibay na siya, na parang immune siya sa mga market correction. Kagaya nito, COVID, tinamaan siguro yung mga office demand sa USA to, no?
Yes.
So ayun, but breakdown EMMA 20.
Not just that eh. Oh. Yung minention mo din kanina na parang related din siya sa yields or sa yeah, sa returns ng bonds, corporate bonds, treasury bonds, 'di ba?
Ayun mga ka-investa. I hope na na-enjoy nyo yung video na ginawa namin ni Ray. It's just the first part, so it's an introductory video to REITs. So pinaliwanag natin kung paano ba gumagana yung REITs, what do we expect out of it, how has it been in the other regional markets, and ano yung mga usual returns. So makikita nyo sa kada bansa, ranging from 2%, meron din 8% na dividend yields, di ba? Tapos we looked at yung mga top performing REITs sa Singapore, kita natin na per annum, price action and dividend yields put into consideration together, it moves around 7-10%. So this answers our expectation na hindi siya kagaya ng mga normal na stock IPO na pwedeng umakyat easily na 20-50% or magsi-ceiling play. Diba? Yan yung isang tanong eh, sir, para bang APV ayan? Hindi. hindi siya ganun, di ba? So the REITs are designed to be more of a passive investment. So para sa mga conservative or mga institutional investors na naghahanap lang ng consistent returns. So hinahambing natin yung REITs, ang pinaka benchmarks talaga nito, either corporate bonds, mas secure lang yung mga bonds, pero in terms of yung constant returns, di ba, sila yung magka-level, at saka preferred shares. So pinakakalapit nito is yung preferred shares. So stock pa rin siya, may shares pa rin, pero hindi siya halos binibili for the price appreciation. More of hinahawakan lang siya dahil sa constant dividends niya. So, doon natin makikita kapag nag-analyze tayo ng REITs, lalo sa mga sa next video natin. So, tapos na tayo sa part 1. We're gonna take a look at a deeper look into the fundamentals of the A-REIT company. And then, mako-compare din natin. So, how does 4%+ dividend yield compare to what's out there in the market? Yun yung una mong pagbabasihan eh. Yun yung titignan ng mga investors. Alright? So, I hope na nakatulong sa inyo tong video na to. So, subscribe lang kayo. Follow us on our social media channels, on our YouTube, para antabayanan nyo yung susunod na parte. We're gonna take a look at A-REITs, and we're gonna look at the prospectus as well. So, mas deeper fundamental look na to. So, yung research process, papasimplihin namin sa inyo, and I hope that you enjoy this video. Kita-kits ulit tayo sa Investagrams.